Hi, and welcome to my de-stress workout number 4 in the series. So today we're going to work together for 20 minutes. We're going to get those cortisol or stress levels down. We're going to get the endorphins or happy hormones releasing. So we've got 5 exercises, 45 seconds on, 15 seconds off. We're going to do 2 sets back to back. Then we'll get another fresh 5 exercises and the same thing. So you need to treat the first round as a warm-up because we're going to go straight into it. And just be sensible with where you're at the moment. Go at your own pace, listen out to what your body's telling you. Have some water ready. You need a mat and optional some dumbbells or free weights. Cans of beans are fine. I would go light if you are gonna take the weight option, but otherwise body weight is absolutely fine. And that's it, so let's crack on with it. So nice and easy first round, okay? First exercise we're gonna do is actually a side-to-side knee hop. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, and stick. And then we're gonna go like this, 2, 3. We're gonna try and hop through it. If you want to, you can march through the first set. Okay, we're ready to go?
Yes.
All right, here we go with the timer. Okay, let's do it, 45 seconds on. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. It's a bit of a tricky one. Moving side to side. 1, 2, 3. Don't have to go massive distance. 2, 3. Just nice and light. Keep the abs engaged as you go. 2, 3. We're using the arms a bit as well to help with balance, but also to just make this a full body exercise. 5 more seconds. 3, 1, 2, 3. Good. Nice. Okay, rest. 15 seconds. Next exercise, you're going to walk out on the mat to a hand plank. Then you're going to tap one bum cheek, bring the arm back, tap the other bum cheek, bring the arm back, and walk back up. You ready? Let's go. Bend the knees, walk it out, tap one bum cheek, tap the other one, and then walk it back. Stand up tall and repeat. Try to keep your hips still as you do this, as you lift the arms. Try not to open up the hips too much. So you're going to super squeeze through your abs and legs to keep your hips level. Good stuff. 15 seconds. Reach round and really try and touch your bottom with the palm of your hand. That opens up your chest more, stretches out that shoulder. Maybe there, and rest. Good. Okay, next exercise, side crouch, and we're going to upper body twist. So what we're going to do is nice feet nice and wide, like a side lunge, but we're going to swing with the arms and get some torso twists. Let's go. 45 seconds here. Try to stay low in your hips, so try not to bob up in between too much. Just go side to side. Just show you side on, see if that's helpful. Good, so really swinging the arms, take the shoulders round and look round as you go. Get a bit of a squeeze through the shoulder blades. So you've got 10 seconds everyone. So your chest is nice and open. Okay, rest. All right, next one. You can take your weights if you want for this. If not, just open hand is fine. We're gonna open the arms out like this, squeeze the shoulder blades together, and then we're gonna hinge. We're doing good morning, so we're gonna hinge and up. Okay, let's go. Hinge, straight back. You can have a soft knee, that's fine, but just not really bending the knee, because the idea is that it's not a squat this, so you're just hinging back at the hips, hinging forward with the chest. And the hips push back. Keep your back nice and straight though. Chest lifted and squeeze those shoulder blades. Well, that's really hard. If you picked up weights like me, I'm regretting it now. Last 10 seconds. So you should feel this down the backs of your hamstrings. And this is really good for your back as well. Right, back exercise. Okay, rest. we're going to go to the wall. If you don't have a wall, you can do this on the mat. I want you to do a narrow press up and then a wide press up. So you're going to adjust your hands each time, okay? All right, let's go. So narrow, elbows skim your rib, and then wide. Watch your nose on this one, remember. Narrow and wide. If you want to make it more challenging, take your feet further back, and then you're pushing more weight. So just go in and out with the arms. Great arm and shoulder exercise, but also core, because you're trying to keep a nice straight plank, so squeeze in that belly button, keep your legs strong and engaged. If you feel a bit wobbly, take your feet apart. Take a step apart with your feet, nearly there. Okay, awesome. So, that's our first five. I'm just going to turn the timer up slightly and we're going to go again from the top, which is side to side knee hops. I'm going to try and do the right leg this time. One, two, three, that's it. One, two, three. I've got it this time. One, two, three. So you're sort of landing on that outside. Two, three, leg and stick. It doesn't really matter. Now I'm going to try and lift up the knees nice and high. Abs in, keep the lower back nice and secure. Two, three, you land and stick. That's quite challenging. Nearly there, five more seconds. And rest, good stuff. Now it's back to walk out on the mat and then we're gonna tap that bum cheek. Look, take that arm and rotate it around, tap with your palm of your hand is good for the shoulders. You ready? Okay, let's go. So walk it out, nice strong hand plank. Have your feet about as wide as your mat. Gives you stability. And stand up. Boom. So tap one side, tap the other side, keep the hips level. Stand up tall. Nice, we're halfway through this round. For this exercise. Make sure you stand up tall in between each time. No shortcuts. Last few seconds. And rest. Good. Next up is our wide stance. And we're going for this side to side. Basically, I'm going to hit the wall otherwise. So nice wide legs. I'm going to come into a side lunge and just twist with the torso, keeping low in your hips. Okay, you can really sink down now. So just transferring your weight straight across from side to side. Get that torso twist. That really works your abs and your core, oblique muscles. So try to look up, follow that hand as it lifts up. Great for flexibility, this one as well. Ooh, makes me a bit dizzy. It's all a bonus, 10 seconds. And rest. Good stuff. Okay, good mornings. So it's this one, I'm gonna do it without the weights this time. And hinging forward. Nice straight back, chest up. Keep your chest lifted the whole way through. So I'm trying to find the right angle, a good angle to show you. There, I think. And then when you stand up, don't forget to squeeze the glutes. Squeeze that bottom. Keep your shoulder blades squeezed together. Really work at that. That's great for your posture. Good. Right, let's keep going with 20 seconds now. So again, feeling this one, the good mornings, back of your hamstrings, even your hamstrings, back of your thighs. And you might even feel this a little bit in your back, but in a good way. Squeeze the shoulder blades, last few seconds. Whew. Oh, and then it's narrow push up and then wide push up. So either on the mat or on the wall. I'm going to use the wall today. You ready? Let's go. So narrow and then push back and then go wide. Open up the arms. So try to keep your abs really switched on. Pull in with that belly button. And your legs strong. Remember, to increase the challenge, take your feet further back. And also, bring your feet together. That makes it more wobbly, hard, therefore harder. If you are a bit wobbly, just open your feet, take your feet a bit wider like this. Ooh, I find those narrow ones really hard because you're using fewer muscles. Just readjust. Last few seconds now, yep. Good. Okay, and rest. Right, that's our first set done. Hope feeling good already? Awesome. Okay, so we've got a little bit of rest and then we're gonna go to our second set of five exercises. So carry on resting. We're going to, now's a good time to have some water. I forgot mine inside, never mind. And then we're gonna change the exercises over. Look, so that was your set one, scribbles. And set two is coming up. Change this over. There we go, look. Set two. Da da da. Don't be put off. I'll keep you posted what we're doing. I'm going to turn the timer up again because I'm still a bit faint for my liking. All right, are we ready to get going with set two? Hopefully, you already start to feel good. Reset the timer and we'll be off. Give me 2 sets, by the way. Do you like my vintage rodeo CNA ski top? Literally, this is about 30 if not 40 years old. Okay, we're ready to go. First exercise we're going to do is a 2 bounce reverse lunge. So what we're going to do, we're going to step back and we're going to go 1, 2, step forward and then switch. 1, 2, nice and simple. So you can take hand weights if you want, if not body weight is fine. Right, let's go. I'm going to grab my weights for this. So I'm going, stepping back, 1, 2, and then forward, and then switch legs, 2. That's it. So you can just take the weights like this, just keeping my shoulders back, squeezed together, shoulder blades. Trying to stay upright, tuck the pelvis under the tailbone. I'm trying to say tailbone and pelvis at the same time. Tuck your tailbone under, engage your abs, pull your belly button in. If you want, you can do a little bit of a bicep curl, but no biggie. If you're just carrying the weights, or if you're not at all, it's fine. Okay, rest. Good stuff. Weights down. The page keeps blowing over. Okay, so next one, running man or running person. Running lady. It's this one, it's a real throwback. It's good I've got my vintage top on. So let's go. So nice straight arms. And we're just pinging the legs back behind. I'm trying to show you on the angle so you can see. And I'm hopping, basically hopping from one foot to the other. Good. So this is just a real cardio exercise. And it gets that heart rate up. So you can go fast if you want. Last 20 seconds, look. I think they used to say in the aerobics videos, double time. I'm going to take my head back to the 80s. When I was just a young child, of course. Last few seconds. And rest. Good. Okay, next one. We're going to use the wall again. If you don't have a wall, you're going to sit into a squat and hold it. If you've got a wall, you're going to sit against the wall. Okay, nice and comfy. And hands away from your thighs. You're going to feel that really heat up through your thighs. If you can, let's do this with the arms. Look, we're opening and crossing, opening and closing the arms. One, because you might as well keep that upper body active. And two, it can serve as a pleasant distraction from the feeling of lead and tightness in the thighs. Good stuff. Keep it going. Now keep breathing. Breath is really important in this one. Breathe into the thighs. Imagine that breath. We reaching all the way down. It's like thighs are steel here. Thighs are steel, we love this. Last few seconds. And rest. Up you get, well done. Ooh, shake those legs. Okay, we're going down into a hand plank. And this time we're gonna tap the feet out to the side. Tap, tap, okay? So come down into box position, ready. Push up into the hand plank. And then you're gonna tap one foot to the side, tap the other. Right, make sure you keep the weight over your shoulders. I'm guilty of this, I often creep back, so I end up like here, because it makes it easier for my upper body. But we need to get that upper body working as well here, because we're moving the feet. So spread your fingertips on the mat, squeeze the shoulder blades together, belly button pulled up, fighting against gravity. Keep your legs strong as well. So nice engaged quads. And breathing. Last 10. Come on, nice and strong. Stay with me. Keep the weight forward. Good. Woo, nice one. We're going to stand up. We've got a squat to do together. So we're going to do what I call under arrest squats. Here, fingertips just behind your ears, not pushing or pulling on your head. Elbows back. And we're just going to squat down, stand up. Each time you come up, what am I going to say? That's right, squeeze your glutes. Just watch your knees and not rolling in when you're squatting, and that those hips coming back behind you. Okay, always, always, always push your hips back rather than pushing the knees forward. This is all about the hip hinge. Great exercise for your thighs, for your bum. Bum toning, butt toning, whatever you want to call it. But more importantly, strong bum. Really important for our overall health. Ooh, I'll talk more about that later. Okay, rest. Good stuff. We've done our five. We've got one more set of five, and then we're done. Hope you're starting to feel good. We're going to go back to that two bounce, reverse lunge. Okay, so if you want your weights, you can. If not, let's go with the body weight version here. Double bounce. So your legs are warm now, your knees and joints and hips, so you can drop that back knee right down. Just mind you don't bang it on the floor, obviously. Get the shoulder blades back and together, down and together towards your spine. And again, if you want to go a bit harder, faster, you can, but just try and keep the depth. Whoop. Good stuff. All right, we're nearly there. Last 12 seconds. Nearly done. Four, three, five then. And rest. Good. Weights down. And we're doing that running person. Running man. Are you ready? So straight arms. Big shoulder extension here. Okay, it's all coming from the shoulder, the movement. And just flipping the feet nice and light behind. So ideally you've got the, like in a sort of walking or running pattern, you've got the right arm going forward when you've got your left leg going forward, and vice versa. If you're not doing that, it doesn't matter. You just might find that you're really wobbly and off balance. So see if you can check it. Good stuff. Okay, last 20 seconds. Let's get double time. Get that cardio, that heart rate up. 4, 7. Nearly there. 2. Last one. Good. Rest. You've got 15 seconds. And, oh, I've got the thigh burner. Wall sit or hold. Sit down in a crouch in a nice squat and hold it. Okay, get ready. Okay, arms away. Try and keep your hands off your legs. Now, the lower you go, the harder this is, but I would. Don't recommend you go like more than a less than a 90 degree angle. Just keep this angle here at about 90. If you start to go lower, you'll collapse, which I don't want you to do. So look, I'm doing this now with my arms as a bit of a distraction from the legs. Thighs of steel, thighs of steel. Here we come. Strong. Okay, keep breathing through this. Remember, breathe, breathe. so nearly there. I can see the counter is on zero something. A few more seconds. Yes. Well done. Okay, so we're going to go down to the mat. Hand plank, and we're tapping out with the feet. If you want to, you can do like a jumping jack down here. It's quite challenging, but give it a go. I'm going to start off with the taps, and what I'll do is maybe for the last 20 seconds I'll go into jumping jack. So remember, get set up right. Make sure your shoulders are under over your hands. Fingers spread out on the mat. Shoulder blades squeezing back and down. Just have your eye line looking down at your mat at a midpoint, and it's just in front of your hands. And pelvis tilted under. If you want to do the jumps, look, this is the jumps. Last 10 seconds or so. Challenge with the jumps is to try and keep your hips down. So you're going to the side with both feet, but you're not lifting your bum up. Woo! And rest. Excellent. One more exercise, and then we're done. It's those under arrest squats. Oh, I'm really feeling that in my shoulders after that plank. So here, fingertips behind your ears, keep your chin tucked in, and we go. Down, squeeze up, squeeze that bum. So yeah, strong bum, really important for overall health. It enables you to do so many things, but also lots of people with lower back problems, they've got weak glutes. Weak bum. So here's a good reason to be happy about having a strong bum. So keep pushing back with the hips, remember. Squeeze the shoulder blades together, make sure your chin is tucked so we're not just creeping the head forward as we do this. Oh, my shoulder's really tight now. Last few seconds, stay with me. And done. Ta-da. Awesome. That's our 20-minute de-stress workout. Hope you're feeling good. So we've got the blood pumping, heart rate up, cardiovascular tick, and the brilliant thing about it is more blood going to your brain enables neurogenesis, which is basically your brain's ability to create new pathways. So that helps us deal with stress and think differently about things. So that's all good. So stretches coming up, if you like, a quick one, 4 minute, or there's a longer one if you fancy doing that. Take care, and I will see you next time for De-Stress Workout number 5. Bye.